Lord, God bless you. Praise the Lord, God bless you. My name is Minister Red, pastor of Christ Our Life Ministries, located in Augusta, Georgia, on 308 Rose Street, directly behind the Walmart Lowe's on Bobby Jones Expressway, Interstate 520 heading west. I pray that you join us for our worship services every Sunday at 11 a.m. and for Bible study every Thursday night at 7 p.m. Thank you for joining me. Thank you for joining me and my members. Amen. Brother Roland and Sister Brittany Peachy, Brother Harry and Sister Beverly Evans, Sister Selena and her beautiful husband Stan, we thank you for joining us today, as well as my sister church in Casita, Columbus, Georgia. Amen. Spirit of Liberty's ministries, pastored by the phenomenal minister Kenya King. Amen. And his beautiful wife, Sister Donna King. Amen. As they hold services every Sunday morning at 8 a.m. and every Tuesday night at 7 p.m. Amen. Join us. Amen. If you want to hear a word from God, if you ever want to hear a word from God, if you're ever in need of a word from God, Christ Our Life Ministries and Spirit of Liberty's Ministries is on the airways. Amen. 3 nights out of the 7 days of the week. Pastor King and Spirit of Liberty's Ministries every Tuesday night. Amen. God bless you, Pastor King. I love you. Minister King is with you every Tuesday night. Then I come Thursday night. Then he comes Sunday. And I come Sunday. Amen. With a double dose. Amen. To help you to live the life of Christ. Amen. So that you can live in the liberty, well, with Christ to set you free. Hallelujah. God bless you. Thank you for joining me today. Amen. Today's message is entitled Thoughts, the Bed of Death. Amen. Thoughts, the Bed of Death. Amen. Hallelujah. Jesus says in Matthew 6 and 25, he says, Therefore I say unto you, take no thoughts for your life. Take no thought for your life, what ye shall eat or what ye shall drink, nor yet for your body, what ye shall put on. Is not the life, watch this, body, is not the life more than meat, and the body than raiment? Take no thought for your life. Is not the life more than meat, and the body than raiment? See, because, you know, when the enemy led Jesus into the wilderness, Jesus had fasted for 40 days. So the first thing the enemy did was the enemy came in and he attacked his fasting life. He attacked his life, and the Lord drove him into the wilderness to be tempted by the devil against. So he says, is not your life more than meat? Was not the life of Christ in Jesus more than the stones that he could have turned into the bread? Oh, yes, it is. See, that's the problem with us today. We are picking stuff over the life. Oh, y'all gonna hear me today. Y'all, we pick stuff over the life, but we pick it in the thought realm. Jesus says in John 6 and 63, the words that I speak unto you, they are spirit and they are life. Hallelujah. The words are spirit and they are life. In Hebrews 1 and 3 says, he upholdeth all things by the word of his power. By the life of his word, he upholdeth all things. Hallelujah. What is your life that you're living today? What is the life you're living in? Is it the life of the word, or is it the life of thoughts? Thought is the bed of death. Hallelujah. So many thoughts run through our head. Hallelujah. Trying to get us to make a decision on what direction we want to go in. Hallelujah. Let us pray. Father, in the name of Jesus, God, I want to thank you for another opportunity to stand before your people in the name of Jesus. Lord, I want to thank you for this awesome word you gave me today to deliver to your people, to set them free from the snares of the devil. In the name of Jesus, oh yes, Lord, we're snared in the hands of the devil all because of thoughts. Oh, the devil has so many of us living on the bed of death, which is nothing but thoughts. Oh God, and we ask you to give us a word today that'll help us to get up off of that bed and to begin to walk by faith and not by sight. Oh God, it might be my voice that they recognize and it might be my face that they know, but let the words of my mouth and the meditations of my heart be acceptable in thy sight, O Lord, my strength and my redeemer. It's in the mighty name of Jesus that we pray. Amen and amen. Hallelujah. The name of Jesus. Thoughts. The bed of death. Hallelujah. Let us go into the word today. Psalms 119 and 105. Psalms 119 and 105 says, thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light under my path. Hallelujah. What is the purpose of having a lamp if you ain't gonna have no light in it? See, thy word is a lamp unto my feet. It is not a lamp unto your, it is a lamp under your feet so that your feet can walk righteously. Hallelujah. Jesus told the disciples, I gotta wash your feet because it was the way they was walking. Peter said, Lord, you're not going to wash my feet. Hallelujah. No, Peter needed his feet to be washed. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. The purpose of a lamp is to give light. The purpose of a thought is to make you think about something so that a decision can be made. Thoughts confuse us, but a lamp will give you light in a situation where you can see and there should be no confusion. The Bible says God is not the author of confusion. Hallelujah. And since God is not the author of confusion, amen, he's always going to give you a word from on high. When God gives you a word from on high, he's only giving you himself. John 1 and 1 says, in the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. Hallelujah. God gives us his Word as a lamp unto our feet and as a light unto our path. The purpose of a lamp is to give light. Hallelujah. And the purpose of a thought is to make you think about something so that a decision can be made. Thoughts confuse us, but a word, if you can get a word, once a person gives you a word, the decision is already made. Once you get the word, the decision is already made. Once you get a thought, you got to make a decision as to what you're going to do. But once you get the word, hallelujah, once you get the word, in the name of Jesus, when they get down to running in a race, the word to be given so that they can take off is the sound of the whistle. In the name of Jesus, the word of God. Hallelujah. Have you heard the word of God today? And if you've heard the word of God, I want to know why you ain't moving, because that word that you heard is a lamp unto your feet and it is a light under your path so that you won't walk in darkness, but you will walk in the light of God's word, because God is light and in him is no darkness at all. And in order for God to get us to walk in the light of his word, amen, he's going to have to do something unto our feet. He's going to have to put a lamp under our feet. When Jesus told Peter to come, all he did was put the lamp under Peter's feet. All Peter had to do was walk on that lamp that was giving him light, that would have made a path to him all the way to Jesus. Thy word is a lamp unto my feet and a light unto my path. But hallelujah, we know that Adam chose the life of thought for us instead of the life of words. Adam chose the life of thought for us instead of the life of word. Those thoughts are called knowledge. The thoughts that Adam chose for us is called knowledge. Our thoughts become our knowledge. God's word becomes our life. I'm going to say that again. Our thoughts become our knowledge. God's word becomes our life. What is thoughts? Thoughts is ideas, images, opinions produced by thinking that occurs suddenly in the mind. Thoughts are ideas, images, opinions produced by thinking that occurs suddenly in the mind. The Bible says, whatsoever man thinketh, so is he. I'm going to tell you right now, God, I don't want you thinking about nothing. God is already telling us through his word, we are more than overcomers. God tells us in his word, we are more than conquerors. We don't have to think about that. We know that. Hallelujah. Thoughts are ideas, images, and opinions produced by thinking that suddenly occurs in the mind. And if you're still in your Adamic nature, then you possess a carnal mind. And if you possess a carnal mind, Romans 8:6 says, for to be carnally minded is death. Hallelujah. Thoughts is the bed of death. Hallelujah, is the bed of death. Whatever that carnal mind is thinking, all it's going to do is put you in a bed of death. Hallelujah. There's a way that seemeth right unto a man. See, there's a way that seems. Hallelujah. When you got seems, that means there's going to be some confusion. There is a way that seemeth right unto a man, but the ends thereof are the ways of death. Thoughts, the bed of death. Hallelujah. The word of God says you're healed. I want to know why you ain't living in that word. But you ain't living in that word because you too much thinking about. You're doing too much thinking about what you can see, what you can feel, what others are saying. Hallelujah. Contrary to what the word of God is saying. And when all that happens, it begins to cause a bunch of confusion in your walk with Christ. We're going to have to learn how to walk with Christ in the fullness of his word, in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. This is what God told Joshua. God told Joshua in Joshua 1:6-7. God told Joshua, my servant Moses is dead. Therefore, I need you to be strong and of good courage. For to this people, you shall divide as an inheritance the land which I swore to their fathers to give them. Hallelujah. Only be strong and very courageous, that thou may observe to do according to all the law which Moses, my servant, commanded you. I'm hearing him and now. I'm going to finish talk here. God told Joshua, the Lord told Joshua, be strong and very courageous. Good morning, my sister Ann, I love you. Good morning, Sister King, love you. God, the Lord told Joshua, be strong and very courageous, that you may observe to do according to all the law which Moses, my servant, commanded you. Do not turn from it to the right hand or to the left. God is saying, I don't care what type of thought you encounter. I don't care what type of idea, what type of image, what type of opinion that's going to be produced by the thinking that occurs suddenly in your mind. I don't want you to look to the left and I don't want you to look to the right. I want you to go forward, hallelujah, that you may prosper wherever you go. See, we look too much to the left and to the right. The thing that's making us look left and right is knowledge. It's knowledge. Hallelujah. Because God ain't gave us the spirit of fear that we should not be able to go forward. Hallelujah. If you ain't afraid. See, the only thing that stops you from going forward is the spirit of fear. If you don't got the spirit of fear, I tell you, you can go forward. You won't look to the left and you won't look to the right. You will go forward. If you are not a go forward person, then that means you are lying in the bed of death. You are prisoner to a thought that you should not be the prisoner of. Here we go right here. But we believers, Sister King, we believers of Christ, amen. Hallelujah. The law was given by Moses, but grace and truth came by Jesus Christ. See, we living under grace and truth. See, Joshua had to live. He had to observe all the things that Moses told him. Hallelujah. But we observe grace and truth. We live by grace and truth. On the Mount of Transfiguration, hallelujah, the disciples, Peter, James, and John, went with Jesus, hallelujah, and the cloud came down, and they saw Moses and Elijah talking to Jesus, and Peter said, Lord, let us build here 3 tabernacles, one for thee, one for Moses, and one for Elijah. But you can't do that, amen, because that will cause confusion trying to get a word from 3 different people. Even 1 John tells us the Word, the Holy Ghost, hallelujah, and God are 3, but they're 1. And these 3 are 1, amen. The Father, the Word, and the Spirit, there are 3 in heaven. The Father, the Word, and the Spirit, and these 3 are 1. Hallelujah, God ain't never gonna author no confusion in your life, hallelujah. The only thing that's gonna author confusion in your life, amen, is a thought in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. But God says, amen, in Jeremiah 29:11, he says, I know the thoughts I think towards you. See, God never give us his thoughts. Hallelujah. He just tells us he knows the thoughts he thinks towards us, says the Lord. Thoughts of peace and not of evil to give you an expected end. See, God's thoughts are thoughts of peace that will give us and expect it in. All we got to do is just believe the word of God. Stay inside of the word of God. His word is peace. God says, I know the thoughts I think towards you. See, Pastor King, I don't know what them other people thinking about you. I don't even know what I'm thinking about you. And you shouldn't care what other people are thinking about you, nor should you care what Pastor Red is thinking about you. All you need to be thinking about is what God thinks about you. Hallelujah. And his thoughts is thoughts of peace, amen, not of evil, to give you an expected end. God's word is a word of peace. That's right, Pastor King. We got to say, I don't care. You wait till I get into this message, Pastor King. I'm going to teach this I don't care thing today. And people are going to see why Minister Red don't care nothing about them and what they think about him. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Proverbs 3:5-6 says, trust in the Lord with all your heart. Why you got to trust in the Lord with all your heart? Because God puts his word in your heart, not in your mind. See, because the thoughts dominate the mind, but the word should dominate your heart. That's why the Bible says, have not an evil heart of unbelief in departing from the living God. If you have an evil heart of unbelief, and departing from the living God, that means you are operating in the thought realm, and you, amen, shall live in a bed of death. It will come to an end for you. You will not prosper. You will not receive anything good in your life. Lean not to your own understanding. What is that? That means, amen, you don't lean to them thoughts you haven't. You only lean to the word of God that you've heard. In the name of Jesus, Trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not to your own understanding. We're doing too much leaning to our own understanding. We sing that stupid song, Lean on Me. Hallelujah. That ain't no Christian song. In the name of Jesus, you don't, the Bible ain't never told us to lean on God. Hallelujah. I know John might have leaned his head on Jesus' chest, but God ain't never told us to lean on his unchanging hand. He ain't never told us to do no type of leaning. God only wants us walking. You'll never see where nobody leaned on their faith in the Bible. See, that's what I'm talking about. Church teaching this thing wrong. You don't do no leaning in the Word of God. All you do is you trust and you walk by faith. Cut this leaning mess out. Hallelujah. Lean not to your own understanding. To lean means what he told Joshua. Don't lean to the left, amen. And don't you lean to the right, amen. Hallelujah. That's what Joshua had to do. Joshua, he had to walk, amen. He says, do not turn from the right hand or to the left. That means don't you lean to the left and don't you lean to the right of the commandments that Moses told you. But for us, amen, of the new covenant church, us that are inside of the Christ life, amen. Hallelujah. It is our job to trust in God's unchanging hand. Hallelujah. Thy word have I hidden in my heart that I might not sin against you. Because in my mind I'm going to sin against you, God. But I'm going to hide your word inside of my heart. Hallelujah. That I might not sin against you. So that I will have it in the time of trouble. In the name of Jesus. God has never given us thoughts. God has never given us thoughts. His will has always been for us to have his word, which is life. And that life is in his son. Hallelujah. 1 John 5:11-12 says, and this is the testimony. God has given us eternal life. And this life, not this thought, not this life. This life is in his son. And his son says in John 6:63, the words I have spoken unto you, they are spirit and they are life. Hallelujah. God has given us eternal life, and this life is in his son. It is called the word of God. Whosoever has the son has life, and whosoever does not have the son of God does not have life. All they have is a bunch of thoughts. If you are not in God's son, who is word, according to John 1:14, that says, and the word was made flesh and dwelt among us, then you are in Adam, who lives in thoughts. The entire world that we live in today is a world of thoughts. Everybody thought that when Kevin Durant and Kyrie Irving and James Harden got together, they thought that they was going to win the NBA championship, because that's what they thought. Hallelujah. But you see what happens when you get in the thought realm. You end up on the bed of death. They didn't win no championship in the name of Jesus, nor did LeBron James in the name, because everybody keep on thinking, everybody keep on speaking, everybody keep on talking about something that they're getting from the thought realm that has nothing to the end of it but the ways of death. In the name of Jesus, if you are not in God's son, who is word, then you are in Adam, who lives in thoughts. And Satan is going to use thoughts to torture you with until you die. Hallelujah. Here we go, Mark 5:2-5. When Jesus was come out of the ship, immediately there met him out of the tombs a man with an unclean spirit who had his dwelling among the tombs. See, he made the tombs his bed in the name of Jesus. And no man could bind him, no, not with chains. But Jesus was not a man. Hallelujah. Jesus was the Word made flesh. But we can say that, then we can call him a man. Hallelujah. The Word calls him the Word made flesh. But he calls himself the Son of Man in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Humbling himself, even though he knew who he was. But to us, he wanted us to know him as the Son of Man. But to God, God wants us to know him as his only begotten Son, who he has given eternal life to us through. And this life is in that Son. And whosoever that has that Son has life. And whosoever does not have the Son of God has not life. Hallelujah. No man could bind him. No, not with chains. Hallelujah. Chains ain't nothing but a bunch of thoughts. See, y'all got all these thoughts. Thoughts is called chains. A chain of reactions. Them thoughts are having you to have chains of reactions. But there was nothing nobody could do, amen, that could bind this man of all the thoughts that was going on in his head, because he had often been bound with fetters and chains, and the chains had been plucked asunder by him, and the fetters broken in peace. Y'all doing everything to try to get somebody to live right, but you ain't applying the Word of God to them. You going through everything. You going through psychologists. You going to doctors. You going to prophets. You going to evangelists. You going to pastors and teachers. You going to apostles, but you won't stop for 1 second, amen, and go unto the Word of the Lord. That's all you have to go to. You don't have to come to Pastor Red. You can go to the Word of God for yourself. Amen. The train was rent in half. The Holy of Holies is open to anybody that comes to God in the name of Jesus. You don't need Pastor Red. Pastor Red is just here to build you up on your most holy faith. I ain't here to tell you how to live Christ. I'm here to build you up on the Christ life that you already possess in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Neither could any man tame him. You think you're going to tame your family members? You think you're going to tame your supervisor? You think you're going to tame the police officer? You think defunding the police officers is going to stop the mess going on in the world? Hallelujah. You got another thing coming. You finna live on the bed of death, because that is the thought you chose to walk by, thinking that that was going to change the situation. You better speak the Word of God. Hebrews 1 and 3 says, he upholdeth all things by the word of his power. Ain't nothing being held up. Ain't no chains being broken, amen. Hallelujah. To where it will be a benefit to you, unless it's the Word of God that's breaking the chain. And the chain that the Word of God is going to break is called thoughts. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And always, night and day, he was in the mountains and in the tombs, crying and cutting himself with stones. Guess what was making him do that? A bunch of thoughts. Hey, amen. You think when he said his name was Legion, that they was, no, there was a bunch of thoughts going on in that boy's head. But when he saw Jesus afar off, see, your problem is you telling people that you got a relationship with Jesus. You telling people you can see Jesus. Hallelujah. This man saw Jesus from afar off. You telling me you seeing Jesus up close. But you still being dominated by thoughts. Hallelujah. When he saw Jesus afar, he ran and worshiped him. See, you don't worship the Lord. Because the Bible says they that worship him must worship him in spirit and in truth, not in thought. In spirit and in truth. What is to worship God in spirit. The words are speaking to you, they are spirit. It is to worship God in the word of God. Hallelujah. And cry with a loud voice and say, what have I to do with thee, Jesus, thou Son of the Most High God? Hallelujah. I adjure thee by God that thou torment me not. See, that's what I'm trying to say. See, them unclean spirits torment us with thoughts. And so because he torments us with thoughts, God has given us his word to torment him with his word in the name of Jesus. I'm going to say that again. The devil and unclean spirits torment us with thoughts. We're supposed to torment him with the word of God. Hallelujah. For Jesus had said unto him, come out of the man, thou unclean spirit. You unclean spirit. You in there and you saying all this mess in that boy's head. And that boy is a prisoner of the thought realm. I come to bring him a word. I come to put a lamp under his feet, amen, so that it can be a light unto his path. In the name of Jesus, you've been walking this boy around in these dark caves for a long time, and everybody has been trying to figure out how they can get that boy to act like he is a normal functioning human being in the name of Jesus. But I come to be a lamp unto his feet. I come to bring a word to him that will be a lamp under his feet and a light under his path. Do you know somebody that is just crazy? Somebody that just won't get right. Somebody that frustrates you all the time. I'm going to tell you how you can stop the frustration. I'm going to tell you how you can stop them from getting on your nerve. All you got to do is speak the word of God to the problem, to the situation. Jesus said unto him, come out of the man, thou unclean spirit. And Jesus asked him, what is your name? And he answered, saying, my name is Legion, for we are many. We are a lot of thoughts. We are a lot of thoughts. Whatever we want to say to that boy, we say to that boy. If we tell that boy, cut yourself, that boy cuts himself. If we tell that boy, throw yourself up against some rocks, that boy throws himself up against some rocks. Our name is Legion, and we carry a bunch of thoughts with us. Thoughts is the gasoline that we use on the human mind to keep that carnal mind functioning the way we need it to function. Because if we ever, hallelujah, stop pouring gasoline, stop pouring thoughts on that boy's head, he's going to get up off of that bed of death and start walking in newness of life in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Jesus says in John 14:27, peace I leave with you. See that? Hallelujah. I bet that's what he told that boy. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give unto you. Hallelujah. The fruits of the Spirit. First thing you need love. You got to have love for people. Then after that, you got to follow up on the message I preached last Sunday. You got to have the enjoyment of Christ. Christ got to be your joy. The joy of the Lord has to be your strength. And then the third fruit of the Spirit is peace. Hallelujah. If you ain't got no love, then that means some thought got you held prisoner. If you ain't got no joy, that means some thought is frustrating you. Hallelujah. But if you got love and you got joy, then peace ought to be able to be all in your life. Because Jesus says, peace I leave with you. My peace I give unto you, not as the world giveth, because the world can't give no peace. The only thing the world can give is a bunch of thoughts. And that's why God says, love not the world, neither the things that are in the world, because the love of the world is not of the Father. I give unto you peace, not as the world giveth. Give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled. Why not should you let your heart be troubled? Because, hallelujah, thy word have I hidden in my heart that I might not sin against thee. Don't let your heart be troubled, amen. In the name of Jesus, neither let it be afraid. The only reason why you're afraid is because of a thought. Hallelujah. You got to get out of the thought realm and get into the word of God, which is life and peace in the Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. In the name of Jesus. Mark 4, 37 and 39. Jesus told his disciples, let us go over to the other side. I preached it, hallelujah, three sermons ago. The sense. Hallelujah. There arose a great storm of wind. Hallelujah. All that means is a great problem came their way. And the waves beat into the ship so that it was now full. Hallelujah. That means waves ain't nothing but a bunch of thoughts. A bunch of thoughts started coming into the mind of the disciples because they chose not to go to sleep with the master. I told you, when you are in the sense is the time between then and now. And the only time Jesus is awoke in the sense is when he's reconciling us to God. Other than that, Jesus is asleep, because if you are awake, the enemy can play with you in the thought realm. Hallelujah. The thoughts began to beat on the mind and on the hearts of the disciples until the thoughts had completely filled up their mindset. And Jesus was in the hinder part of the ship asleep on the pillar. And they awoke him, saying unto him, Master, they were telling him what they was thinking. They were telling him what they was thinking instead of the way they were supposed to be living. Master, carest thou not that we perish? And Jesus arose and rebuked the wind and said unto the sea, peace, be still. Hallelujah. Peace, be still. Peace I leave with you. My peace I give unto you. Not as the world giveth, give I unto you. Let not your heart be troubled, neither let it be afraid. Peace, be still. And the wind ceased, and there was a great calm. See, when you put the word of God on it, hallelujah, the thoughts will begin to cease. And there will be a great calm coming over your life. But hallelujah, if you don't speak the word of God, Sister King, if they don't speak the word of God, then there ain't never going to be no peace in this situation. Sister King, all we got to do is speak the word. Hallelujah. And don't look for the manifestation of it. Mm-mm. Never look. See, Sister King, that's the problem. We speak the word, and then the enemy gets us to thinking that we're going to see the manifestation of it. Mm-mm. Mm-mm. Hallelujah. God told Abraham, your seed will be put into bondage for 400 years. Hallelujah. There was people in the seed of Abraham, Jacob's children, that never saw the manifestation of Moses. But did Moses show up? Oh, yes, he did. You might not see the manifestation, but don't you worry about that. You hold on to God's unchanging hand. Not everybody's going to get to see the manifestation of the word of God. But don't you, then you just die in faith. Then you die in faith, believing that word. Don't you allow no stormy wind to cause you to abandon ship. Don't you allow no strong wind to get you started to waking up. That word is hidden on the inside of your heart. Do not wake up that word and say, word, carest thou not that I perish. Don't you wake up that word that you've hidden in your heart, talking some foolishness that you got from the thought realm. In the name of Jesus, the word of God is not thought. I'm going to tell you that again. The word of God is not thought. If you know the word of God, if you hear the word of God, if you hear the word of God spoken to you, that is not thought. Jesus says the words are speaking to you, they are spirit. Whenever you hear the word of God, whether you're hearing it spoken out of my mouth, somebody else's mouth, or whether you hear it in your own conscience, amen, that is spirit. That is the anointing. You have an anointing from the Holy One. You need to no man teach you nothing. Hallelujah. Pastor Red don't have to teach you nothing. All you got to do is believe and hold on to that word that you've hidden on the inside of your heart that is not a thought. Never think that when you hear a word from the Lord, that it came from the thought realm. It came from the mouth of God. It came from the Holy Ghost living on the inside of your breath of life. It's called faith. So then faith comes by hearing, and hearing by the word of God. You always going to hear faith, whether you hearing it from me, or whether you're hearing it in your time that you spend with God. But the only way that faith comes is by hearing from the word of God. That is the only way faith comes. Faith comes no other way. The law was not a faith. Galatians 3 and 12, for you people taking notes. Galatians 3 and 12 says the law is not a faith. Hallelujah. So then faith cometh by hearing, not by you keeping the law, not by you going to church on Saturday, not by you not eating no pork, not by you not wearing no pants, not by you not having your head covered. Faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the word of God, and not the law of Moses. Comes by hearing by the word of God, and not the law of Moses. Here we go. The three Hebrew boys never thought about the fiery furnace. You see, but Nebuchadnezzar thought that if he made a fiery furnace. Hallelujah. But the three Hebrew boys never thought about the fiery furnace. Daniel never thought about the lion's den. But the people that thought they could tell the king, nobody should pray to their God. Hallelujah. But Daniel didn't listen to him. Daniel never thought about the lions in the lion's den. See, if you never thought about it, if you never think about it, then it can never touch you. I'm going to say that again. If you don't think about it, it can't touch you. In the name of Jesus. David never thought about Goliath's victories. Amen. Even though Goliath, everybody knew about Goliath in the victories, and that Goliath had never been defeated in battle. But David never thought about Goliath's victories. The woman with the 12-year issue of blood, she never thought about the crowd. All she said was, if I may but just touch the hem of his garment. I wonder where she got that from. She had to get it from the faith that was on the inside of her. In the name of Jesus. Here we go. The NFL teams in the year 2000 never thought about drafting Tom Brady until New England took him in the sixth round. He ends up being the greatest quarterback ever, the quarterback in the NFL. But nobody never thought about it. It was six quarterbacks taken before Tom Brady was taken. Take no thought. Hallelujah. But y'all think that, y'all listen, y'all think that them people that go, they spend all that time thinking they drafting the right person. Hallelujah. Portland thought they had the right person with Sam Bowie. He ended up letting the Chicago Bulls get Michael Jordan. Portland thought they had the right person in Greg Oden. Hallelujah. Oklahoma City ended up getting, hallelujah, Kevin Durant in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Take no thought. Hallelujah. Trust in the Lord with all thy heart. Lean not to your own understanding. Your thoughts are only going to put you on a bed of death. That's all they're going to put you on. Hallelujah. Here we go. 2 Kings 5:10 through 12. Hallelujah. King Aram sent Naaman, the commander of his army, to Israel, to the king, and told him, I need you to heal my commander of his leprosy in the name of Jesus. The king got mad, rent his clothes in the name of Jesus. But the man of God, Elijah, heard about it. He said, oh, king, you think too much. I told you I am a man of God. I got the word of God. Send him to see me in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. When Naaman, the commander of King Aram's army, went down to see the man of God named Elisha, amen, he thought Elisha was going to come out and talk to him, but Elisha didn't go out. Amen. Elisha sent his messenger, Gehazi, to pass on the message. Y'all gonna hear me today. You think sometime God, amen, because y'all operating in the thought realm so much, because you live so much in the thought realm, God has to give us, amen, pastors like me who have learned through the Spirit of God how not to live in the thought realm. God, because you live in the thought realm, God sends me as a messenger carrying his word to tell you to go wash yourself 7 times in the Jordan in the name of Jesus. Elisha sent a messenger to say unto Naaman, go wash yourself 7 times in the Jordan, and your flesh will be restored and you will be cleansed. But Naaman went away angry, just like some of y'all. When I keep telling you, come out of that masonry mess, come out of that Eastern Star mess, come out of that Alpha Kappa Alpha mess, come out of that Omega Psi Phi mess. Come out of, amen, that Republican mess. Come out of that Democratic mess. Come out of that Black Lives Matter mess. But you ain't coming out of it. You doing what Naaman did. You going away mad because you saying in yourself, I thought this was a good organization. I thought this was a good decision. You know what? All the other black people are out there protesting Black Lives Matter. I don't want them to think that I'm not with them in the name of Jesus. I ain't with you. I'm with the Lord. Who's on the Lord's side? If you on the Lord's side, then you are on the side of the word. And if you ain't on the Lord's side, then you are on the side of thought. Naaman went away angry and said, I thought that he would surely come out to me and stand on the name of the Lord his God and wave his hand over the spot and cure me of my leprosy. Are not Abner and Paha, the waters of Damascus, better than all the waters of Israel. Ain't the preaching of Joel Osteen and T.D. Jakes better than the preaching of Pastor Red? Ain't the preaching better? That dude mean. That dude preach mean. Hallelujah. Couldn't I go wash in them and be cleansed? Couldn't I go walk in them? No, because you got ministers out there that support that Black Lives Matter mess. You got pastors out there that allow Masonry and Eastern Star mess in their churches. You can't wash in the word that they teaching you, but you can wash in the word I'm teaching you, because I'm teaching you the word of God, completely void of thought. I ain't thinking about you, and I ain't thinking about nobody that you hang with. I ain't thinking about none of y'all, because I'm too busy, hallelujah, living in the word of God. Hear me? Not thinking about the word of God, but living in the word of God. That's your problem. You thank the word of God. I live the word of God. That's the difference between me and you. If there is a difference, I live the word of God, and all you do is thank it. And that's where the enemy is able to snatch that word immediately when it is sown, because you care so much about this world that immediately when that word is sown, the enemy snatches it away from you. Hallelujah. Naaman said, ain't the waters, ain't the rivers of Damascus better than all the waters of Israel? Couldn't I wash in them and be cleansed? So he went away in a rage. What made him go away in a rage? His thoughts. Hallelujah. He chose to live in a bed of death as a leprous man, then follow the words that Elisha sent to him through his messenger. Same thing y'all do. You choose to stick with them thoughts you got than to choose to live by the messages that I bring every Thursday and every Sunday from God himself. Because you think I'm just a stupid old black human man just like you. You just think I'm some old preacher with no, that don't nobody know nothing about. Naaman's servants went to him and said, my father, if the prophet had told you to do some great thing, would you not have done it? How much more then when he tells you, wash and be cleansed? So Naaman decided he was going to get up out of that bed of death and walk in the life of God's word. Naaman got up out of the bed of death. What is the bed of death? Naaman said, I thought Naaman was in the bed of death. Naaman was in the realm of thought. Naaman was in the thought realm. Naaman was in his Adamic nature. Adam chose the life of thought for us instead of word. The thoughts are called knowledge. Naaman had knowledge of them rivers in Damascus, and he also had knowledge of the rivers in Israel, but he did not have knowledge of the word of God that was sent to him from the messenger of Elisha, who was a prophet of God. In the name of Jesus, my name is Minister Roderick Andre Red. God has called me into the fivefold ministry. I am a pastor and a teacher of the Almighty God.
from on high, the one that you say is your God, yet you can't hear the words of the mouth of his messenger when I preach and teach to you every Thursday and every Sunday. You are still choosing to live in the bed of death. You still choose to walk in the realm of thoughts. You don't know how to deal with them ideas, them imagines, them images, them opinions that are produced by thinking that occurs suddenly in your mind. You just can't get it together. Forget Pastor Red. Who does he think he is? Who does he think he's talking to? I ain't talking to you. It is God talking to you through me. I'm just a messenger. Hallelujah. That this word slays also. Oh, the word of God gets me too. I ain't special. But hallelujah. But I'm going to tell you this. If God's going to get me, you better believe I'm going to get you in the name of Jesus. So hallelujah. Naaman decided in verse 14 that he was going to get up out of that bed of death that is called thought. And when he got up, he began to walk. Job 17 and 9 says, the righteous keep moving forward. Naaman began to believe the word of God. And when he began to believe, he began to move forward. He began to move forward. And the next thing you know, hallelujah, he went down. He moved so close to the Jordan that he went down into the Jordan. Hallelujah. And when he went down, amen, he dipped himself the first time. And then, hallelujah, I pray that he wasn't trapped in the thought that he was supposed to be cleansed on the first dip. The word of God says, dip yourself seven times. That's what he told Naaman. But he told us all we got to do to be cleansed of our Adamic nature is to be baptized in the name of Jesus one time. One time is all it takes to be baptized in the name of Jesus, so that you may experience the outer resurrection life of Jesus, which is called Christ. Amen. Hallelujah. So Naaman went down and dipped himself in the Jordan seven times. It took Jordan, it took Naaman seven times to be able to talk about the outer resurrection life of Jesus. But water baptism enables us to talk about the outer resurrection life of Jesus on just one baptism. It took seven times. Seven is the perfect number. You know why Jordan, you know why Naaman had to go down seven times? Because God didn't rest on the first dip. God didn't rest on the second dip. He didn't rest on the third dip, nor did he rest on the fourth dip. He didn't rest on the fifth dip. He didn't rest on the sixth dip. But on the seventh dip, God rested from all his work, and Naaman was cleansed of his leprosy, as the man of God had told him, and his flesh was restored and became clean like that of a young boy. What did Naaman do? Naaman chose to live. 2 Corinthians 10 and 4. 2 Corinthians 10, 4 through 5. Something Satan nor many of us have chosen to do. Something that Satan nor many of us have chosen to do. Naaman chose to live. 2 Corinthians 10, 4 and 5. For the weapons of our warfare are not carnal. Hallelujah. See, he had carnal weapons. He was naming them rivers in Damascus. But they're not mighty at all. But our weapons are mighty through God. What is God? God is word. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. It was mighty through the Word to the pulling down of strongholds. What is strongholds? Them thoughts, amen. Casting down imaginations and every high thing that exalted itself against the knowledge of God, which is the Word of God, and bringing into captivity every thought, every bed of death that the devil puts you on. The Word of God will take that bed into captivity to the obedience of the outer resurrection life of Jesus. Hallelujah. Christ, the outer resurrection life of Jesus. Christ is the life that went into death and came out of it still living. The outer resurrection life of Jesus. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Here we go with Satan. Let's see. Ezekiel 28:14-15. The Lord says, you were the anointed cherub who covers. Anointed, meaning he had God's word. That's what anointed means. You have God's word. 1 John says you have an anointing from the Holy One. You have no need to no man teaching. Satan had the word of God. You were the word of God possessing cherub who covers. And I placed you there. Hallelujah. God placed you here on planet Earth not to be a prisoner of thoughts, but to have dominion over it. And you were on the holy mountain of God. You walked in the midst of the stones of fire, which is thoughts. And you was blameless in your ways because you kept walking in the word from the day you was created until unrighteousness, until iniquity, evil thoughts was found in you. Unrighteousness are the thoughts we believe and live by instead of the word of God, which is truth. Thoughts make us think we are so smart. Thoughts make us think we're smart. We get them from text messages, billboards, articles, podcasts, conversations with the ungodly, newspaper articles, experts on all types of events, Twitter comments, persuasive emails, news reports on the TV, radio shows, YouTube videos, direct mail pieces put in your mailbox, books written by people. We will win the battle of thoughts only when we renew our mind constantly with the word of God. Samson thought he could tell Delilah his secret. David thought he could kill Uriah secretly and get away with it. Achan thought he could steal from Jericho and not get exposed. Y'all thought Simone Biles was going to dominate the Olympics. She did too. Haman thought he was going to have Mordecai killed on a gallows that he built, but he ended up getting hung on it himself. Married men think they're going to cheat on their wife and not get caught. Married women think they're going to cheat on their husbands and not get caught. Drunk drivers think they're going to get drunk and not get caught. I tell you, I'm so amazed. You know, here in Augusta, I know it's in every city, they got this newspaper called The Jail Report. I mean, I look in that thing and I be like, drunk drivers page 4. It ain't like the police ain't out saying we're going to be out looking for drunk drivers. It ain't like they ain't telling us they're not going to be out there. Many people thought they could smoke and not get cancer. Kobe Bryant thought he could get on the helicopter and fly
to the other side and have basketball practice with his daughter. See, that's what the enemy says. Thoughts. Thoughts is the bed of death. You thought, yeah. You thought you was gonna drive 55 in a 35 and it wasn't gonna be no cop out there. You can be sure that your sin will find you out. Numbers 32 and 23. Be sure that your sin will find you out. Your sin ain't nothing but your thoughts. Even though Jesus told us to take no thought, we still keep taking thought. And every time we take a thought, that thought puts us on a bed of death. Take no thought. It will prevent you from sleeping on the bed of death. But you can't take no thought. Jesus says in Matthew 6:25, I say unto you, take no thought for your life. Take no thought for your life. Hallelujah. Oh, God bless you. Thank you for joining me for today's word. Thank you for joining me. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. While we are so busy walking around in thoughts, don't worry about nothing. Why are you doing all that mess? Don't worry about nothing. Our Father is still kind. Even though we walk around in thoughts, our Father remains kind because He is Word and He changes not. Watch this. What's this first four words?
Our Father is kind to His sons and daughters, never denying the blessing we can be.
See, we don't have to think about it.
His love,
we don't have to think about it.
Do it all.
All them thoughts. He is faithful.
And proves it. Our Father is kind sons and daughters, never denying their blessing, we can be sure in love and those through it all He is faithful and proves it again.
So we must learn how to trust Him all the more when we don't. How circumstance, him as them thoughts, now lead to what's in store. But you made us for greater, so we can be sure that your love endures when we struggle along the way. When our trouble, him as them thoughts, overwhelm my day. But watch this.
There is good news for all who
it's called the Word of God.
God is our Father and saves.
The Word is our Father.
Our Father is kind.
The Word of God is kind. Oh yeah, the Word of God is kind. Hey!
Our Father is kind.
Yes. Yes, yes He is. God is kind to His sons and daughters.
We can be sure.
We can be sure. God is kind. You think a thought endures? No, no, no. His love endures the thoughts.
Window.
for your journey.
Say peace for your journey. Everything is in his hand. Eve let go, Achan let go, Naaman didn't let go, hallelujah, Naaman didn't let go, hallelujah, the three Hebrew boys didn't let go, Daniel didn't let go, hallelujah, Samson let go, but Samson got it together. And then Samson held on to the end. Hallelujah. Never let go. Never let go. Stay off of the bed of death. You have the word of God on the inside of you. That word will keep you off of the bed of death, which is the realm of thought. God bless you. I love you. I will see you Tuesday night with Minister King at 7 p.m. at Spirit of Liberty's Ministries. I love you. Amen and amen.